Thank you. How's everyone else doing? All right. Thank you. Above average. That's good. Who enjoyed yesterday's presentations and activities? All right. There we go. I was blown away by the presentations. They were awesome. And the energy and the activity. I feel very tired today. But thank you for everyone's participation. So I just have a couple, actually just like one administrative note. The Sotmas tradition is to do a group photo. We've done this every year, and we're doing it today. At the same time, we're doing a satellite selfie from space. And I was talking to people about this yesterday, and they didn't believe me, but we actually are doing this. So it's not a joke. I was joking yesterday. This is not a joke. We did this in Seattle last year and in New York the year before, so we want to make it 3 years in a row. We need the weather to cooperate. We are going to have both the group photo and the satellite selfie out on the terrace, which we were on for the reception last night. It's where the Birds of a Feather is. So everyone will just have to file through. There's signs that show where the Birds of a Feather are, and we're going to be out on that terrace well, I'll tell you what time. Okay, this is what happens with a satellite. So just so happens I work for Digital Globe, so I was able to call in a favor. WorldView 3, which is one of the coolest satellites in space, is going to be powering over the Utah-Colorado border at 17,000 miles an hour, and it's going to look this way. So it's going to be over Utah. I know there's a bunch of people from Grand Junction. It'll probably be over Grand Junction, and it's going to look at Grand Junction in the house. Thank you. Yes. Love Grand Junction. So it'll be over the western slope. So if you're in Grand Junction, you'd see it right above you. From here, it's going to be like at an angle, and it's going to look at us at Boulder. And at exactly 12 o'clock, 12:28 and 35 seconds, 35.3 seconds, the camera will turn on. And 3.3 seconds later, the camera will turn off. Now, I can't slow the satellite down. If we're not out there, I can't ask for a redo. So we have one chance to get out there. All right. So we kind of, and I'll take the blame for this. I didn't get these exact times till yesterday. So we're looking at our schedule this morning. The second session was scheduled at 11:40. Just kidding. The new schedule will be at 11:10, and we'll try to update the website. You'll see on the schedule, we have a lot of buffer this morning, so we have a lot of extra time this morning, and we're supposed to do coffee at 11:10. Coffee will probably start at like 10:50, 10:45, and then the new schedule will start at 11:10 a.m. We have to do that because we have to finish at 12:10 p.m. so that we have 18 minutes to safely and cautiously get 400 or 500 people out on the terrace. Is everyone cool with that? All right. That's it. So thank you. And again, apologies for the last second change. And I'm going to turn it over to Kate, who's going to say hi and introduce our incredible keynote speaker.
Good morning, everyone. I was trying to remember when Emily and I met, and I'm not sure. It involved crisis mapping. It was a while ago. But I've always admired and followed and just really been in awe of her work as executive director of Digital Democracy. And I was so excited that she could come here today and share with us. I'm not going to go any more into that because Emily has an amazing story to tell, and you can read her bio in the program if you want more details, and I think you should. Emily, come join me. Thank you so much for being here today.